I'm Florence Balladay 3060, staying safe in quarantine. Alright guys, we're back to filming Miele. Today she is going to be trying out the Finnish Luvil Bio Colour with Tesco Bio Fabric Conditioner, and she's going to be washing my bathrobe. One of the only machines I haven't done the bathrobe. I highly doubt the 9530 will do that. I don't really want to do that to another one. It's a bit dirty at the moment because Mum's just finished washing up. So yeah, we're going to do that on minimum iron 60. Reason for minimum minus, different cycle, a bit better rinsingness, and also switched off the out of balance sensor. Well, the switch off just makes it less sensitive. So I'm going to get putting that in and see how the machine copes with that with a higher water level as well. Those are up. I've checked the pockets, so there's nothing in there. That'll obviously come out by itself, but I'll take it off now anyway. She's done 260s today. Good. Alright, so I'll shake a bit of that into there. I like going by shaking the box on this. Stop. Now the Tesco conditioner I use this because it's also for sensitive skin. I'll put another half cap in there because I do want it to be really soft. Switch the machine on. Turn the program dial to minimum on 60. I will also select water plus, and we will do a short on this one. And yeah, actually, no, I won't do short. Oh, don't know, that's quite a long time still. And 17 will go. Enjoy. You lost. Upstairs, I think. Where? Oh my god. Mum's using her glasses and the clock too. Okay. I'll sit that in the dryer while I go and have my shower as well. After I do this. Maybe a few top up fills. Actually, remember the machine does use a lot more water. I've just heard the click of the heating elements coming on. So this is the performance mid-main wash after the mid-heating top-up fill. That
shows you quite a subtle detergent.
It's a very absorbent item, so it's not like there's too much water in there, but even still. Very strange. Unless that does smell quite nice. And being the 55 RPM tumbles as well, or high dramatic. That on the shoulder rinse now. Step cool down. Steps cool down.
It's not a shoulder rinse.
Fill again. It's a bit like what the whole point does on the synthetic stuff. There you are. First one to me to spin, let's see what happens. I'm going into idle care mode, and I think she'll still rebalance. Yeah, even that's unbalanced enough. Oh my god. Ooh, thick. Whoa. Told you this cycle doesn't though. Doesn't care about balancing all the subsocks, to be honest.
I think there's one for the suds to pump out. That's a 600 RPM burst now. Much prefer doing it in this machine.
Up
And on the first rinse, deep level. Second intermediate spin, with the golden jumping shift themselves.
At least the machine's got the extra rinse added. Unbalanced? Nah, not yet. Still sort of not too much there though. At least got balance for this one. That's good. I managed to get most of that water out. Hey, deep level, second rinse. This is the additional rinse. Hopefully most of the sludge should be kicked out by now. And followed by another spin, and then final rinse. I've noticed machine will do, deep level rinses. Do a good job though getting the water out of the machine of the bathrobe. At least it's not too vigorous on the bathrobe either. bloody good water level. The only thing I do, the only gripe I have about the cycle, I wish the intermediate spins were a little bit longer and probably just a little bit faster as well. Third intermediate spin now, third and final intermediate spin. Yeah, it's gone down. I just hate how this always gets left on the wall. It's like no matter what you wash, it'll always happen. It seems to be very well with the balanced spins though. So I feel like it's going off, guys. Oh, unbalanced. I wonder if we're going to stop and rebalance for that. There's no way the machine will spin that. Oh my goodness me. Really, I've underestimated you. Told you, this cycle doesn't care about balancing. The cotton cycle will be a bit more fussy with that. Final rinse, deep level. Talking the Tesco Pure Sensitive Skin now. Tesco Pure Sensitive Conditioner. Saturates the conditioner in. Now the main fill, and now all the suds disappear away. Sorry guys. Final spin. I thought the machine was going to do a 7-minute final spin, which is actually going to do probably some like 5-minute lot. So we're going to miss out a burst then, I guess. What's the burst? There we go. Nice and balanced. You guys see okay? The tangles in between, and then she'll do an 800 RPM burst and then the final round up. Oh, you're spreading it around the drum quite nicely. Pretty damn fast there. I don't want to use the other lamp because that's way too bright. Wish this camera had a thing. A light on the... No, I found a lamp up. I found this one. It's all the drum shot. That's all under. Very much like vintage machines these are, with the way they spin. It'll be nice and fluffy once it comes out of the dryer. Beginning of March, I wash it every month. Unload, there we go. Very nice. Combined with the conditioner, Tesco conditioner, that's done a very good job. Water drain away, that's fine. Ooh. So guys, that's the Miele that's now used, Luvil Bio Colour, lovely House of Fraser Bathrobe. Won't be doing the bathrobe in the 9530. That's not a good idea. Unless we did it with something, maybe, I don't know, a blanket or something I might be able to do it with, and stick it in there with that. So we're going to resume videos on the 9530, but now I've got to do one unboxing video of a 1980s hairdryer and travel iron set, the Black & Decker Stowaway one, Stowaway Travel Twosome. I'm going to do maybe another one of the Creator dryer, I don't know, at the moment. Might just wait till I get a new dryer and see what happens. We got that. So, anyway, guys, thank you very much for watching that. I hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to keep it supreme and go with the flow.